Hey everybody, it's Brian here. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing great. So a few days ago, I received a comment on my channel where I was asked, hey Brian, great, but how can I fill multiple letters or numbers using the Canva? For example, using a national flag and saying, for example, made in the UK. So it was a question that was posed to me, and obviously, given the fact that this person was probably having some difficulties, I thought, what a great opportunity to show how to go about creating such a design using Canva. It's really not that difficult at all. It's actually quite simple once you get the hang of it. And once you actually master this technique on Canva, you can actually utilize it for basically any design for your print-on-demand business. You can utilize it for your social media posts. Basically, the world is your oyster with it. So if you're interested in seeing how to go about creating such a design on the free version of Canva, then there's only one thing left to say. Let's get to it. Now, before we continue with today's episode, the fact that you're here means you're interested in all things pertaining to print on demand. And for that, I want to thank you wholeheartedly for taking the time out of your busy day to sit down and watch this episode. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to smash that subscribe button and click the bell notification icon so that you'll be informed each and every time that I upload a new video to my channel. I upload new videos every Wednesday and Saturday, and the scope of this channel is to help you take your print-on-demand business to the next level, not only necessarily with respect to your design making, but indeed your marketing and social media posts as well. So with that said, let's head over to my computer and start with today's tutorial. So welcome to my computer screen, and as you can see, we have Canva up on the screen at the moment, and I already have the design basically already fleshed out so that you would actually be able to see what the final version is going to look like. And what I also did was I also put it on a black background so that obviously the whole component of made in the USA would actually stand out. Now, you don't necessarily have to limit yourself just to made in the USA. You can use this effect for basically any country that you wish to create a design for. And again, you can actually utilize this particular technique for basically any kind of phrasing that you wish to use. So effectively, it's all the same technique. All you have to do is just place your letters appropriately on the canvas size and then just go to town with inserting the graphics. So let me show you how we did that. So the first thing that I did was open up a canvas with the dimensions of 4,500 by 5,400, which as many of you know, is the merch by Amazon dimensions, so that effectively I could utilize the design not only for my merch by Amazon shop, but indeed for any and all my print-on-demand platform shops that I actually utilize. And I made a duplicate of the page here. And then what I did was I went into frames. So if you just click on elements here and you type in frames, okay, you're going to have all of the frames that Canva has on offer. And basically what frames are is just sort of like a shape, letter or number that you can then put onto your canvas and then superimpose another video, another photo, a clip art, basically anything that you can upload onto Canva, you can actually embed into the shape of the frame. So it gives you a lot of versatility, a lot of flexibility, a lot of creativity. So what I did was I scrolled all the way down to frames until I got to the section pertaining to the letters. So again, you can use this technique that I'm going to be showing you, not only necessarily with respect to letters, but indeed any and all the shapes, all the frames that you can find on Canva. So what I did was I obviously brought in all of the letters pertaining to made in the USA, and I sized them accordingly, as you can see here. So I created made very large, and I did in the USA slightly smaller underneath it. Now, what is important for this technique is that the first and the last letter on every line needs to effectively be touching the end of each side of the canvas. So the M, the left side, has to be touching with the canvas side, as is the case with the I, the E, and the A. And the reason why you want to do this is because if you have a graphic that you want to superimpose onto each of the letters that is a little bit complicated in terms of design, knowing that you have your letters stretched out from one margin to the other is going to make it a lot easier when you try to resize your graphic across all of the letters. So it's made in the USA, so we need an American flag, so just going to click the X here. And I already found it in advance, but if you wanted to find it on your own, all you need to do is type in USA flag, just click enter, and obviously it's the first one that pops up in the catalog. You're obviously welcome to go through the catalog and choose any of the other flags if they obviously are better for you in this respect, okay? So now what we're gonna do is we're just going to effectively superimpose that flag onto each of the letters as we're doing here. So we're going to click on the letter M, and then we're just going to click on this flag and we're going to drag it into the letter M. Now, as you can see, it's superimposed within the letter M. And if I want to go ahead and just click on it and put it into all of the other ones, I could do so, but the problem is that there's no uniformity, okay? There isn't anything, the flag isn't stretched out across all of the letters, and that's what we want to do. So we're going to get rid of this flag here and double click and hit delete. And then what we're going to do is we're going to double click on this flag here, and we're just going to stretch it out so that effectively it goes over the entire phrase. And we'll just decrease it here. And this is why I was telling you why it's important to make sure that your letters in the phrase, basically the edges, touch the edge of the canvas. Because then once you're doing this, once you're duplicating this procedure, it's going to be a lot easier to line up everything so that obviously it looks very consistent amongst all of the letters. So I'm not too happy with the fact that we've got a little bit of white here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stretch it down a little bit so that the blue area with the stars is basically touching the bottom edge of the top letters here. Okay, once I'm happy, just click done or click outside of the box. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on A, and I'm going to just basically do the same thing. So I'm going to drag it over to the A, double click, and then I'm just going to stretch it out right across. Okay, and we're going to make sure that the top edges are touching. And this is why I told you it obviously takes a little bit of patience, but as you can see, because of the fact that I lined everything up properly, the stars over the letter A are matching up in size when I overlap them onto the letter M. So I know that I'm perfectly aligned. So I'm just going to click outside to accept that. Okay, so now I'm going to do the same thing with the letter D. So we're just going to click and drag into the letter D. I'm going to double click, and we're going to enlarge accordingly. And then we'll just drag the flag over to the left here and resize so we know that we're spot on, because the stars are going to obviously match. And I'm quite happy with that. Just click outside. And then we do the same thing with the letter E. And this way, in doing this exercise, in doing this technique, you're going to get the impression that the flag was stretched out right across the entire phrase. It's going to look spot on. And we're happy with that. So there we go. We've got made already done. So basically, you would go ahead and do the same thing with in the USA. And once you're done, you're obviously going to get something similar to this. Obviously, it's not an exact duplicate of the one that we're working, because you can never actually get it, you know, precise. But, you know, create it and do it any way that you like. Superimpose them, overlay the flags over the phrase. See what obviously makes you happy. You can actually move around the letters and maybe give them a little bit of a tilt or whatnot. Just be creative with it. Obviously, I'm doing a very basic version here just to get the technique across. And then once you're done, okay, what you can do is you can actually download it. And when you download it, then you can actually re-upload the PNG version that you've downloaded from Canva back into Canva, so that obviously you would get something like this, which obviously would allow you to be able to resize accordingly rather than having to have to resize and move around each individual letter. So you're creating the technique, you're downloading it, and then you're uploading it again, obviously onto a new canvas, and then you can actually place it wherever you'd like and include any clip arts or superimpose it or incorporate it into whatever kind of design that you feel you would wish to upload to your customer base for them to consider making the purchase. Now, once you've actually mastered this technique, you don't necessarily just need to limit yourself to utilizing this technique simply for your designs. You could actually utilize it even when you are creating your social media posts. Let's say you want to create something for Facebook, for Instagram, TikTok, or what have you, and you want to create this kind of effect utilizing frames. Well, you can actually go back into frames. So we're going to close this, and we'll just go click here on frames. And as you can see, we've got all of these different types of frames here. And let's assume for a moment I want to create the circle and this sort of like wavy line circle, sort of like badge type emblem, and put them together and superimpose some kind of photo or any kind of clip art or any kind of design into it. It's very simple to do. And basically, I'm going to show you. I've already went ahead and did one here. I found a sunset, or rather a sunrise landscape. And basically, I put the two next to each other and then actually imported the photos into each and then sort of lined them up to give it a little bit of, you know, sort of this unusual effect, which would be very eye-catching. Remember, you want to make sure that your posts are going to be scroll-stopping, eye-catching type posts. And in using this technique, it can definitely help you to get people to slow down and figure out, hey, what's going on with that particular post? Well, what did the person do with respect to create this particular effect? It's cool. Let me take a look at it. And in doing so, you've stopped them. You've gotten their interest. Maybe perhaps you can obviously then entice them with some text on the social media post to lead them to your respective print-on-demand shop. So let's see how we're going to do this. We're just going to create a new page here. We're going to grab the first circle. We'll just move it around here. And we'll grab this emblem one. We'll just superimpose it here. And again, you can put it effectively anywhere that you like. It really doesn't matter, okay? So let's just say we're going to leave it over there. Now, let's go on to photos, just so that we can, you know, highlight this technique. Again, you can do it with any kind of photo, video, clip art, design, what have you, okay? So let's just, we're going to utilize the sunset one here. So we're going to click on that. I'm going to click on it and superimpose it into... Okay, well, actually went into the emblem one, which is absolutely fine. And I'm going to double click on it. And I'm going to increase it to incorporate not only the emblem, but the circle as well. Okay, and I'm going to move basically where I would want the sunrise or the sunset. Let's call it the sunrise, where I would want it to appear in the circle. All right, so I'm happy with that. We're going to click outside to accept that. And then I'm going to click on the circle. And I'm going to superimpose this over into the circle. Now, what is going to lead me to be able to obviously, you know, align these two designs perfectly? Well, if you can see here, there's sort of like this natural black line in the grass area. So if I had to double click on this and enlarge the photo and bring the sunrise effectively where I want it to appear, okay, as you can see, you've got... Well, the line here is almost perfectly aligned, and you just want to play with it until you get it really spot on and you're really happy with it. And when you are, just click outside and then just clear outside. Now, we're not perfectly aligned here, so we're just going to double click and move it again a little bit more. Again, it is a bit of a patience game. It is a bit of a precision. But, you know, once you do it and once you move things around and get it spot on, it really looks effective. And again, you could do this for all kinds of social media posts. And in doing so, you're actually going to get people to stop and actually take a look and see what it is that you've created. So that hopefully you'll be able to lead them to your shop and obviously make the sale. So there you have it, everybody. As you can see, it's really not that difficult to create. Yes, it does involve a little bit of play and a bit of patience and a bit of, you know, precision. But, you know, in truth, it does take a little bit of time, patience, precision. But hey, once you get the hang of it, it really isn't that difficult. And you can really come up with some fantastic designs for your print-on-demand business to take it to the next level. So I certainly hope that you did enjoy this episode. If you did, please don't forget to smash that like button. It does wonders for the YouTube algorithm. But for today, that's all I've got. And as always, be safe, be well, be creative. Bye for now. Hey, if you enjoyed this video and you want to find out more ways that you can take your print-on-demand business to the next level, why don't you check out one of these two episodes I have over here. And don't forget to subscribe. Catch you in the next episode. Bye for now.